Hey guys, got another repair. This repair, I did a model of this monitor back in 2013. It's the Acer x223w. It's the pink screen of death. Basically all the caps had to be replaced. This one here I've run into, and it's just starting. You can see it in the picture there, the video. When it gets really bad, all this black background will turn green. I get a lot of smearing as well. So we're going to take it downstairs and see if we can actually save it. Hopefully it's caps and not something more severe. I'm guessing it's this, because that's, you know, that's pretty much how it goes with electronics equipment. If it's got, you find a defect in it, then it, pretty much every model's going to have the same problem, right? From what I remember, this one here, when I bought this one new, it started to go like this and just got progressively worse. So let's take it downstairs and rip into it. Doesn't look like this one's been opened at any time, so we're lucky there. The only thing really holding this on is the tape, from what I remember. Yep. And unplug the... try and unplug them anyway. Needle nose pliers when you need them.
Well, right off the bat, I don't see any puffy, caps. It's going to be a little bit harder on this one. I'll check this board here. I don't think there's anything on here. Now, one thing I have noticed yesterday, when it got hotter in the room at night, it got worse. So I don't know if that's because of a bad cap or this is the main display board here could be bad, or the actual LCD itself. There's a chip on that as well. Hard to say. But, like I said, last time I worked on this, it was a cap issue. So. Or this model, anyway. Alright, I'm going to go over this with a loop and everything else and do some testing on it, see what I get. You don't want to see when you open up a monitor is water damage. You can see that white crust on that chip there. And actually, there's a cap next to it that's actually got rust on it. I've never seen that before. But yeah, that's the issue. Some water came in this way, sort of sat around this area here, and all on the high side there. So that would explain a lot. Originally, when I got it, I plugged it in, it wouldn't even turn on. And then as it sat for a while, it suddenly got better. So I don't think it was wet at the time. I think it's just damage from getting wet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically just drench this in alcohol, scrub it down really good, get all the crap off, and look for bad solder or any bad components. That obviously it's probably the power supply is likely weak. That's the issue. That could have been the problem. I'm not ruling out that there is still something wrong with it. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to let it sit down here in the basement in the heat and the humidity and let it run for a while, see if it starts to get to weird runes and stuff in it. That could have been it. Could have been just corrosion on the board, which will do that. But let's let it sit and see what it does. Okay, well, it's been sitting for a while, about an hour or so. I don't know if you can see that, but the U has a little bit of overlap, a little bit of shadowing, as well as some of the icons. I was actually surprised how warm this panel actually gets on the top. It has that steel plate. I'm hoping it's not the LCD that's gone bad, because like I said, it gets worse as it warms up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do what I did in the other video. I'm just going to repopulate or recap that small VGA board, the input. And if that's pretty much process of elimination. I mean, if it's anything else, it really can't be fixed. The backlight display and all that stuff on the board is good. I have no problems with the display. It's nice and bright. Like I said, it does generate a lot of heat, the top plate of this LCD. And there is a chip inside there that could possibly be bad. But let's just do the board and... You know, if it doesn't help, then there's nothing we're going to do for it. The power supply is sound. Like about these Amazon kits, they're nicely laid out. Makes my job much easier. There isn't too many odd sizes here. I think four of these are all the same. This one's different, this one's different, this one's different. So, shouldn't take too much. Just gonna dig through this and see what I got. This one a little bit neater than I did the last one. My last video, I just basically hit them sideways and soldered them down. It worked. This one here, I draw them right through hole. And they're to spec. Everyone is matched up. The only ones that were oddball were these ones here. I still got the same specs on these two brown ones. They're just smaller. So, but the capacity and the voltage is the same. So, we'll see if that works. Looks like that was it. Like I said, I found a few more problems than just recapping the board. Was it that? I don't know. But I do know that the high side IC and the low side two ICs on the other side, they were all basically, there was just, the chip was just up against the heatsink. There was no grease. So they could have been overheating and then cycling or whatever to protect themselves from frying. That could have been the problem. I'm going to go with the caps, but I mean, I did find a lot of other problems with it. Hopefully I never run into one of these again. Like, they are nice monitors. They're getting so old. Like, this one here started chipping off. That's the problem when you design something that's made to just toss in the garbage. Like, if they were to put screws in the back of this, you could service it a couple of times and keep it going, keep it out of the landfill, but no, they designed it so it snaps together. So when the plastic starts to harden, it'll start falling apart. Which, you can see there in the corner. It's normally chip out like that, so kind of sad. We need to stop designing stuff like this.
Much better. You can see the green. There's no hazing or smudging. Definitely got it. This repair only lasts about maybe 2 or 3 years before those caps will fail again. We'll see. Later, guys.